So it's 9:30 now. I don't feel like I really need to use this to talk to you, but I've been instructed for the webcast to use this. My name is Carla Reyes. I am an assistant professor of law at Michigan State University College of Law, where I also direct the Center for Law, Technology, and Innovation. I've been volunteering with the Dynamic Coalition on Blockchain Technologies for a while. And at the end of a little bit about this session, this is an interactive session, not a panel discussion. So if you are hoping to be spoken to for an hour and a half, this is not your room. If you are interested in working with us to build the work program for the next year and to contribute to what the products of the Dynamic Coalition looks like for the next year, then this is absolutely your room. But be prepared to participate. I'm a professor and I'm not afraid to put my professor hat on and make you participate. The idea of the session comes from last year's session, actually. So there was a panel last year, and as a result of the panelists' discussion afterwards with members of the participants of the session, there was a nice working group that sort of organically created itself about legal frameworks for decentralized autonomous organizations. And they've been working all year, and they presented their initial sort of thoughts and findings at DevCon in October, I guess, and they're still working on writing out a report on that. But the idea was came up whether we could scale that out so that there could be additional working groups, and that the topics could come organically from participants in the Dynamic Coalition. So that's what this session is intended to do, to give you all an opportunity to design the next year's intersessional work product. So the idea is there will be six, depending on how many people come in, six working groups, and I need four more facilitator volunteers. But we've got one facilitator over here, one in the middle there, if you could raise your hand and let folks see who you are. And I could use two on this side if you're willing to facilitate, which just means take notes. You don't really actually have to facilitate. That's my job. But if you'd be willing to take notes and make sure people sign in. Oh, come on, you can do it. I'll assign. Okay, I knew you were going to do it. You got here early. It's the early folks. Anybody else? I need one down there. I know you want to. Okay, I'm going to come down and assign you. I'm not kidding. and probably we could use one more down in this corner. All right, the person with my pen. I got it. So let me do that, and then the first 10 minutes, so I'm keeping it on time, so the first 13 minutes worth, the idea, you've got instructions in your sheet, or in your seat, I should say, and the first 13 minutes worth is to get to know each other and to learn about what your interests are in being here, like why did you come today in the first instance, what do you do when you're not at IGF, and what's your interest in blockchain, and then from there you'll be able to talk decide sort of what governance problem you'd like the coalition or maybe your working group of the Dynamic Coalition to work on. Now, I should say, if you're part of one of these small groups, you aren't necessarily obligated to continue with the work product throughout the year, but we would love it if you would volunteer to do that, yeah? The idea is, again, to scale up participation and enable you all to work on the things that you're interested in working on as part of the coalition. Okay, if you have questions, I'll be coming around. One of you just got home.
not expecting interactivity. You're also welcome, I'll just say. But it's absolutely interactive.
Thank you.
Hello, a brief interruption to say, if you haven't stopped introducing yourselves yet and started talking about governance problems, then now's the time to do so, because your time for step one is over. I've already had a couple of questions about the governance problems. There's two ways to go, either governance of blockchain technologies or some part of the technology stack, right? Or blockchain technologies as it relates to internet governance more broadly, right? So whichever one your group is interested in pursuing, or both, right? As you might see in the instructions, the next step after this is to just brainstorm ideas of governance solutions, yeah? So it could be a whole bunch of things at this point. Okay, thanks.
Thank you. different of the Republican thing, having the government. Because as she mentioned, blocking her can be used for voting.
Right.
Or like agreeing with the other government participating. So we get this control, bring that in knowledge, and adopt them from the we have different backgrounds, different religions.
So we have some sense of blockchain for public application.
Okay, this is your facilitator interrupting to say at this point, we want to move to the session, the part of the session where you think about ways that you'd like to see the dynamic coalition contribute to solutions to the problems you've been discussing so far. So in what ways could the coalition build tools or reports or anything that would help address the governance problems you've brainstormed at this point? Okay, I'm coming around if you have questions. And sorry, one more announcement. If you're a group facilitator, this means that you're on page 2 of the notes with the arrow that points to ideate. So you're going to you're going to take notes. Just a reminder that you're going to take notes. Please. Hello, this is your friendly facilitator interrupting for a moment with instructions for the next step. If I could have your attention, please. Hopefully at this point, you have been brainstorming potential solutions to the governance problems that you identified earlier. At this point then, you might want to begin evaluating those potential solutions. There are four criteria on the instruction sheet for you to consider as a starting point, but they need not be the only criteria. These, however, are criteria designed to ensure that we as a dynamic coalition can actually achieve something in the next year on the item that you've identified as your priority topics. And it's also with a goal of helping you identify which solution to those priority topics might be your priority for the future year. It's designed to be on a score scale. You don't have to do it that way, but it's one way to do it without, or to make it easier to score your potential ideas in order to whittle it down and choose one. Again, I'll be coming around if you have any questions. If you have not yet, because lots of people have come in along the way, please do sign in on the sign-in sheet that's sitting in your group somewhere so that we can make sure to include you for going forward. Thanks. Hello, it's time for another interruption from your friendly facilitator. If I could have your attention for a brief moment, I'm sorry. It sounds like I'm interrupting good in discussions. But at this point, hopefully you have been evaluating your options. To the extent you've narrowed it down to one or two of your favorites, now would be the time to think about what the output will look like and what the first steps in creating the output, sort of going forward from this session into the future, might look like, so that we can then put it into action. So really, I'll be sending out emails in the next several days so that we can put it out into action over the next several days. And that was all. Thanks. You've got 15 minutes for this part of the exercise, and then it'll be time to sort of share outputs, a discussion among everyone, right? One quick report out, and then that'll be it. Thank you. Okay, at this point, our group discussions have come to an end, or our time for our group discussions have come to an end, although I recognize you're still actively discussing. Nevertheless, if you could turn your attention now to the whole group. At this point, I'd like to ask each group to report out on the one or two, as the case may be, project ideas that they'd like to see move forward and the very next steps that they think are required in order for that to happen. Perhaps starting with the group that just told me they were done. Do use your microphone and maybe say who you are when you speak. And if you were a note taker, before you leave the room, please do connect with me so I can get the notes so I can type up a report to distribute to the whole listserv after the fact. So all right. Yep. Group one.
I'll start. Absolutely. So my name is Walid Al-Sakaf. I'm one of the co-founders of the Internet Society Blockchain Special Interest Group, and I've been in this, and we've been before on panels in the past at IGF, and I was happy to moderate the group that had 9 members. Out of them, we have a diversity of backgrounds, and I'm happy to report that we have come to a conclusion, that's an output that we'd like to propose, and a group that's already committed, actually, to go on with the steps. And before I even present the score, the output, let me say that we wanted to see to it that this project can be of value to the community as a whole. So we gave overall a score of 4, above 4 if you take the average, but not quite valuable. We have a lead already that's agreed to take on, Leah Richard. I think she might want to say exactly what the output will look like, so I give her the word.
So it's still super fresh, but we're thinking of launching a mapping exercise, aiming at relying on the personal data taxonomy related to blockchains. So to be extremely concrete, when you look at XPubs, hashes, public addresses, etc. The exercise would be to take use cases and for the different use cases, see whether or not they can be considered personal data. So that requires a first phase of interviews with businesses, governments, even civil society, if they have blockchain projects ongoing, see how they process their data, see if they have any specific awareness around how they process those XPubs, etc. And depending on what they do, making an assessment of whether or not these data can be considered personal data, and then going back into a visualization exercise of where you could see an internal system for the use case versus their blockchain system versus the blockchain versus the internet and how they're integrated.
Thank you. Yeah. Group two. Briefly, so I note we have 4 minutes before we get kicked out.
Sir, I just wanted to ask the question, is that in relation to European kind of approach to personal data and GDPR?
Be the baseline, yes, starting from the definition of personal data of GDPR.
Okay, so group two. Try to keep it short. We had a head-to-head race on two topics. One of them was GDPR in terms of how to get clarity into that. But the topic we agreed on that is most pressing and needs really solving is we imagine that we need some kind of wiki for blockchain, mapping all the different regulations and legislations and stakeholders, and we would propose the DC to create that kind of wiki in a collaborative approach with a multi-stakeholder attitude or approach to create this wiki within the next 12 months.
Thank you. Group three. We've still got 2 minutes.
Okay, very briefly, we had very intense discussion actually about topic number two, the relation between blockchain technologies and the internet governance. In the end, we came up with the idea that, let me find my notes, that data governance would be a very good topic for blockchain, actually. Data ownership and sovereignty. So, how can the government make sure that the use of personal data can be granted and then revoked to companies, to hospitals, to other people? Yeah.
Thank you.
And group also, sorry, and the identity.
An identity. Group four.
We came with three proposals. I'll be very quick. It was how to educate the public on blockchain. Setting up, the second idea was setting up a framework for a multi-stakeholder organization that can certify that government blockchains have integrity. And the third one was establishing a government readiness index or set of standards for whether they're ready or not to implement blockchain. We picked the second one, the multi-stakeholder framework. I'm going to pass it to my friend.
As the blockchain is one of the emerging technologies, that's why we have to clarify what kind of the stakeholders will be interested in the blockchain. And we will ask to the expert groups and the multi-stakeholder groups to finalize a framework of the blockchain, how to bring.
Thank you. And group five in 30 seconds.
30 seconds, okay. So we viewed the blockchain in the context of the decentralized web and the challenges that that will bring. We found that the, you know, the decentralized web of the future is designed primarily by engineers, and that policy tends to be an afterthought rather than a design consideration. We also thought that there were challenges to identity and sort of how modern identity online will differ from the identity that we currently know on the web. The outputs that we decided to make from this were basically, there needs to be a baseline of knowledge within governments that allow them to discuss these issues from a point of, on top of what is a blockchain, that tends to be a stumbling point. So the outputs were an organization that is responsible for educating and delivers a set of resources, organizes conferences, and is basically a support for policymakers to help to design these policies. We think it's 4 out of 5 super useful.
Thank you. I'm super encouraged by the fact that several of you came up with similar ideas. So you're, even though it was your second choice, it's still going to go forward, right? So we'll have 5 exciting work products to work on for the next year, and I look forward to working with you on each of them. Now, if you have sign-in sheets or notes pages, please see me before you leave the room. And if you can help me put the chairs back where they go for the next session, that'd be much appreciated. Thanks very much.
Thanks. My armpits are...